Isaac Lowe, age 21, 11-0 with 4 knockouts, defending my English title on the 21st of November against Ryan Doyle.
Lee Ogan here, the IPTV, down with Isaac Lowe. Isaac, how you doing?
Good, Lee. Thanks for coming down. Just finished my training session. Some good sparring.
Good 10 rounds there, mate.
Yeah, good 10 rounds in the first 10 rounds with Josh and... I forgot his name now. Maxi, young amateur come over from Hull. I forgot his name now, but he's a good amateur kid. He's awkward. He comes with all different styles, so just mixing it up really. We've got Maxi, obviously Southport. We've got Joshua coming forward, and we've got him from the young amateur, who's fast with his hands.
And well, we thought we'd come down, and obviously you're going to be fighting on this show on the 21st on the undercard of the Crowler Perez 2. But we'll just try and find out a little bit about yourself. What was your amateur career like, mate?
Yeah, I had a pretty decent amateur career. I think I had around about 55 amateur fights, 54 amateur fights.
And how many did you win, mate?
I lost about 8 or something like that, if I can remember. Somewhere around about 8 or 9. Or
something pretty damn good, then.
Yeah, done all right. Got a few national finals. I never actually won. Only what I won really was I got silver medalist in the Three Nations for England.
Mm-hmm. So you boxed for England?
Yeah, I was the first senior year. Northwest Order of the Belt, knowing the belts first come out, I was age 17. Always as an amateur, I was a great amateur, but as you probably know, being pro, I always have a professional style of going forward and fighting.
Yep.
So basically when I got age 18, when I had the chance to turn over, it suited me more with the pro game.
You've been a pro 3 years now?
Yeah, 3 years, maybe 4 years coming up, I think now, yeah.
Well, I met you about a year ago down at Jamie Moore's gym. You were in between gyms, yeah. And you were doing a little bit of training down there.
Shane Foster was gone in there.
Young Foster, prize fighter, and you had Andy Colhoun just started down there then. But I think the boxing world noticed you first when you fought on the undercard with Josh Warrington.
Yeah, I think...
And you won your title.
Obviously fighting with Steve Woods on the show, so a few people had to be, but no one really knew who I was on, obviously no one heard. But when I fought on, obviously, Josh's undercard, I think the full boxing world got to see me, and obviously everyone's on about me now, and they got to see who Isaac Lowe is, and there's more to come for me.
Well, you've got a top 10 ranking now, number 6, are you, mate?
Yeah, number 6 in Britain, so that's a good ranking, obviously.
And I think Jim Watt was quite old in the top there. I was really impressed with it, both of you. I think both VIP, you and Josh, stole the show that night.
It's great for Steve Woods too, obviously, for having two VIP boxers, obviously. Josh, first and foremost, is obviously in verge for a world title shot, and then he's got me, who's coming through and basically making big statements in the boxing division at my weight now.
Yeah.
I said not many people heard about me, but I said on the lights on that night, I made a big statement, because no one, maybe everyone expected me to win that fight,
yeah.
But they didn't expect me to win it in the manner I did it.
Well, not many people stopped Jamie Spate.
Exactly, you know what I mean? So the manner I'd done it and the way I did it, obviously I opened a lot of people's eyebrows, and obviously a lot of people's talking about me now. I got the likes of Jim Watt, who was talking about me a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of other boxers, everyone, as I said, I'm ranked number 6 in England now.
So yeah,
people will be looking at me and people will be chasing me, because people want my belt, they want something what they haven't got. So.
And when you won the belt, you had a big friend there, didn't you?
Yeah, big friend there, obviously. Tyson's a very good friend of mine.
What is he related to you?
No, he's not related to me, but I've known him. He's just as good as related. He's like my big brother more than anything, do you know what I mean? He's watched me since I've been a baby, do you know what I mean?
He's a big brother, though, isn't he?
Yeah, he comes to every fight, even when I'm training, when I'm back home.
Will he be at this fight because he fights a week later?
Touch and go, obviously, because it's a week before his fight. Hopefully, I think he's flying over to Germany on the Sunday or something, so he might get down... Because it's in Manchester, he might get a chance to get down. If not, I understand the reason. He's got bigger things on his mind.
Yeah.
But I'm sure he'll get to watch on Sky Sports in here.
Well, listen, I really enjoyed that. And now it's set up a great match because you're fighting another VIP fighter.
Yeah, Steve's taking me back in the deep end again, isn't he? He's stepping up one more time. He's taking me in with Ryan Doyle, which is I have respect for Ryan. He's a good kid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He's a good come forward fighter. He's aggressive. He's someone like myself who doesn't like boxing. He doesn't like a boring fight. He's always in good fights, and I think it's one what a few boxing people who knows boxing knows it's going to be a great fight. Do you understand?
I'm really looking forward to it. Again, I think it's still the show here because I know how Ryan fights. He's a come forward fighter, but a bit clever. And I mean, I was a bit nervous for him because obviously he had to win his fight, which he fought last Saturday night.
I was nervous
night,
myself,
it?
To be honest. It was only because I didn't want him to do was get any cuts or to get any energies, because it put me out of my fight. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I would have got no one in. So.
Well, he fought a very controlled against one of your ex-opponents.
Yeah,
you beat, but it was only over 4 hours, wasn't it?
Yeah,
when you fought him. Because I know how Ryan fights, he likes to get in a bit of a war, a little bit of a battle. And that kid's short. You know, the kid who just fought Simone.
Simone, I know what you mean, yeah.
Well, he's a bit like Ian Bailey.
He just comes forward and he's awkward. He's something like that. Because when I fought him, he was in with his head and clumsy. But
yes,
thank God Ryan got through, do you know what I mean?
Well, he fought a really, really good
Yeah, I watched a bit of it on VIP boxing. He usually jabbed well, do you know what I mean? He boxed more than obviously what I thought he would have done. So.
Definitely.
But listen, as people says, me and Ryan's going to go on, and we know, Ryan knows and I know, at some point in that fight, we're going to have a war.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I know that. It's putting your body through it. But obviously, it's not going to start off as a war. We're not that... Well, if Ryan comes to me from round one, I want to stand toe-to-toe, I'll tell him now, he knows that he's going to get knocked out. I'm being sensible. Listen, I'm not being... There's no way can Ryan Doyle stand with me for 10 rounds. So I know for starters, he'll start using a bit of a brain. I know he's clever enough, and I'm not calling him because he's a decent, good kid, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think he's going to use his brain for a bit, and then I think later the fight goes on, we'll get into it.
The camera can't see me, I'm smiling because I know how good this fight's going to be.
Yeah.
You're both very, very hungry fighters. You want to get
to
the
next
level.
You
want your title, and you want to go on to, hopefully, maybe challenge for the British title sometime next year.
Oh, yeah, so get this fight out of the way. And then hopefully next year you've got Ryan Welsh, you've got, you know what I mean? Listen, I'm not calling people, I haven't got my own fight out of the way yet, do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But there's big fights to be made next year. But obviously Ryan Doyle's in front of me, and he wants what he hasn't got, do you know what I mean? And I want to keep what I've got over Christmas, do you know what I mean?
So it makes for a great fight.
It makes for a great fight, and it's a local derby. Do you know what I mean? I know I'm from Morecambe, he's from Manchester, there's only, do you know what I mean, it's North West Derby, so I'm fully, fully looking forward to it. I know Ryan's going to be 100%.
Well, is it 3 weeks on Saturday, is it, mate?
Yeah, 3 weeks on Saturday. I know Ryan's going to be 100% prepared. I'm going to be 100 million percent prepared. I've got the best team around me. I can't thank my trainer Dave and Jimmy, like Span with Josh and them. I've got some great trainers.
Well, I mean, this is it. It's Josh and Maxie, I mean, it's after just 10 rounds there. And it went down like that.
I flew bad, I said to you,
was that six? And you went, no, 10. I went,
fucking
heck. That's how you know you enjoy it.
Yeah, well, listen, I enjoy it. Look, as I said, if I can do 10 rounds with the likes of Maxie and Josh, hard, toe to toe, when fight night comes, no disrespect to Ryan, he can't bring what they've got, and he can't handle. And I'm a class above him, and I want to prove that on November 21st. When I go on that ring, no doubt in my mind, I'll go in there and I want to do a complete job on Ryan Doyle, and that's no disrespect, because I'm not calling Ryan Doyle, because listen, he's a great kid, do you know what I mean? I hope for all the best, and we're going to go to war, but and people's going to see the best of Isaac. The fight last time was good, this is going to be a 3 times better one.
Right, well, that says it all then. Obviously, I can't say I hope you win, because you both are fighters, so may your best man win.
Yeah, thanks very much.
I know I will be smiling at the end of it either way, because I know you're going to put on a great show, both of you.
Yeah, well, win or lose, and we'll be friends after it. We're friends now, do you know what I mean? I'm not here to call people bad names and that, do you know what I mean?
You're both talking about it,
and we're both showing, we both give the fans, and trust me, people's on about Anthony Crowley's being top of the bill. They want to keep an eye on this one, because this is going to be one, you blink and it could be over, do you know what I mean? So I know that, and I'm looking, listen, that's what I want to be in as an English champion. Big, big fights, and fight towards 50-50, you know what I mean? What people's underestimating me a bit more, saying, oh, it's going to be closer than what he thinks.
Mm-hmm.
And, but listen, I want pressure on myself. I've told you once before, when I fight on a big stage, I'll prove.
And you did last time, mate.
I proved last time, and I'll prove once again, and this is going to be the best. So, go tune in. I just want to say a big thanks to Dave and my trainers, anyone, because you've got to think the trainers, even for Ryan, the people who does the training for us, do you know what I mean? The trainers deserve more respect than anyone, do you know what I mean? So.
You're the ones who having to do the hard work, so good luck for 3 weeks on Saturday.
3 weeks on Saturday, yeah, so tune in. And still, number one coming.
Isaac, take care, kiddo.
Thanks very much for coming down, Lee. Cheers, everyone.